All right, welcome back to American Harley Garage. Today, we're going to replace the brake pads on the front and the rear of my 98 ElectraGlide Classic. The only tools I'm gonna need to do this, give me an Allen, 5/16, long screwdriver, and I like to have a wrench for a breaker bar just in case these are tight. So I'm gonna start by doing this one here. Came out smooth. Slide that out there. Let's grab my new pads. Should slide right out of there. There we go. We're gonna take that out there. Forgot about that. So that's going to be an 8mm. I'm going to use a 1/4-inch socket. Brake pad just falls right out right there. And there's the second one right there. Like that. just gonna slide right back in there. There we go. Screwdriver. I'm gonna need to compress this. There we go. So I guess I should have told you to compress that in before you take your brake pads out. There we go. Now I'll pop that out. Now this one has the screw hole for this. So that goes on the inside. This one goes on this one. It's just common sense. Now we're just going to slide it on. Now we're just going to slide it onto the rotor here. Alright, what's throwing me off is this hooks into here. Alright, come on now. So that hooks into there. But if it's like that, see, it needs to be back there. All right, I'm gonna have to go look at the book again. Make sure I do this right. I'll be back. And that's why it's always helpful to have a manual. The problem I was having was this fits right here in this tab right here. But obviously when I hooked it on and the brake pads were so much thicker, I didn't have enough room to slide it onto my rotor. So looking at my manual, this needs to be, yeah, there we go, pressed all the way out. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Now, if I can just get this back in there. Now, I have more than enough room to fit that onto my rotor. So very carefully, so I don't scratch my paint, I'm gonna slide this on there. In. Now I'm going to repeat that process on the other side. All right, well, I was just going through the book again, reading over the procedure. I got all my tools and everything set up on the other side. I put a piece of wood under my kickstand to just give me a little bit more room. Now this side we're gonna do exactly like the other side. That's what bothers me though, is this one's flush, but it's not flush on the other side. Yeah, that's sticking out right there. There's something not right on this side. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that side and then come back to this side and figure out what the problem is there. This brake pad should have been replaced a long time ago. Scratch on my finger. I learned from the other side is you want to keep your brake pads in first and then compress that down. use this. Oh, and that should now compressed evenly. There we go. Open that right up. All right. Now we can open up the brand new ones. All right, and again, there's one that has a screw hole, one that does not. The one with the screw hole goes on the inside right here. Sits in there just like that. That sits in there just like that. You see the holes line up perfect. Why that doesn't fit. It fit the other side. Nice and even, all right. All right, thought I had a dead battery, but it was a full SD card, so. I threw another 64 gig in there. Should be good for a little while. All right, let's pop this in here. Like that. Everything's lining up. All right. I never want to tighten up one of them completely tight until you get them both started. Now let's see if I can get this one in. like the other side, or like it came off. And now it's stopping again right there. It must be doing that because the brake pads are that much thicker, so it's not going to go in all the way. That's all I can think of. But again, that's why I have a manual. I can go back and read about it. You don't want to forget to tighten this back up. If that comes off or goes flying, or this brake fluid gets on your nice paint job, it will eat away at it and ruin it. Oh yeah, look at all that. That would have been all over my tank. And the reason this isn't flush anymore is because of that plunger that I pushed out so that little clip would fit right in that spring. I pushed it about a quarter inch. So that would make sense why now this bolt is going to stick out about a quarter inch. So that was the front brake pads. As you can see, I also picked up some rear brake pads. So now we're going to put those on.